Almost everyone knows the story of a carpenter, a cross, a grave, and a resurrection. But these are all parts of a much bigger story, the story of God's boundless love and infinite compassion. Jesus went to all the towns and villages, and when he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them because they were helpless, like sheep without a shepherd.
They gathered around to listen as he talked of heaven's grace. He knew the power of pictures could not quickly be erased. matter where he traveled, there were questions that he faced. And everyone who heard him was constantly amazed.
When we think about Christ, it is easier for us to picture a powerful healer and teacher who commands the winds and the waves and communed only with his heavenly Father. Yet because of his humanity, Jesus had friends he cared for very deeply. The scriptures tell us that he had a deep love for Mary and Martha and Lazarus. It was only natural for them to send for Jesus when Lazarus fell ill. He was not only a miracle worker, he was their friend.
Truly he cares for us.
ears. Now everyone's saying that he's almost here.
I'll fall to my knees as he comes through the gates.
I'll worship the one who is worthy of praise. Great is the Lord our God. Great is the Lord our God. We've seen his power. We've seen his praises. Great is the Lord.
As the disciples began to prepare for the Passover meal, they could hardly have anticipated all that awaited them in the following hours. From a lesson in humility to watching one of their own revealed as a traitor, they stood helpless as the serenity of Gethsemane was transformed into a place of despair and resignation. They endured a mock trial, a crown woven from thorn branches pressed on the forehead of their master, and the anguish of a Roman cross. But through it all, it was impossible to ignore the evidence of compassion. Even the thief who hung at his side sensed that truly there was something different about this man.
Look at me. Any room for me?
let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him, he endured the cross, the scorning, its shame, and he sat down at the right hand of the throne of God.
Such love.
No matter how you get there, no matter what you bring, there is room at the cross for you. For sinners seeking forgiveness, for the weary who long to find rest, and for the broken who need a place to heal, and the cross offers compassion. He endured death for you and would not have to. He paid the ultimate price for sins he did not commit. Not only is there room at the cross for us, there's also room at the empty tomb for us to take a look inside. To be amazed with Mary and the disciples, he is alive. He is risen. He has conquered death so that we may live eternally. And he invites seekers to come, not to grieve, but instead to celebrate.